Now, the second principle that will help set a foundation for our next steps is the idea that we should use HTML tags that are meaningful to the content that we're wrapping them around. In our simple case, this means using H1 tags for a heading and P tags for a paragraph instead of div tags for them both. And here's why. Given that we can style an HTML element any way we want to, why shouldn't we just use divs for everything and just simplify the process of creating content structure? The thing is that it takes a little while to figure out exactly which HTML tag is right for the job in different situations, so just using div tags might be a bit of a shortcut. So, good question. There are a number of reasons why we should put out the effort to make sure our HTML tags line up with what we really intend to say with the content. Another word for this is called semantic HTML, which means HTML that has meaning. So the first reason, which isn't tied in with meaning directly, but which can give visual meaning to different elements on a page, is that the default styling in a browser can be useful. So for example, if we didn't add any styling to the example that we're working with, the browser would give the heading tag a much greater weight on the page, and that gives the necessary visual cues to know that it's a heading. Also, a lot of the times we'll actually want that heading to be bold, we'll want it to have a certain margin, and so it can save us time when writing CSS. But even if you're not really appreciative of the default styling of the browser, and you decide to get rid of it all, which we'll talk about later as one option, there are many users on the web that use screen readers, which means that they're not actually seeing the visuals in the browser at all, but they're relying on the tags in the HTML to derive meaning from the content. These people could be blind or visually impaired, or using a screen reader for some other reason. When using a screen reader, headings are particularly useful for navigation, whereas generic divs don't give any meaning at all to the screen reader, so they don't know exactly what role it plays on the page. We'll talk a lot more about screen readers as we get into the discussion around accessibility and ways we can make our code even more accessible for those people who are using screen readers. Another audience that we can cater to with using the right HTML tags are search engines. Now, we might not know exactly how search engines are processing the content on the page or what it gives weight to, and there are other ways to give search engines information about particular content on the page, like using microformats, which we'll also talk about later. But ultimately, designing your page with meaningful HTML assures that you're at least giving search engines some sense of the content on the page and how it's structured. That allows them to properly index the content and also display the content in various search engine results in a meaningful way. And finally, using the right HTML tags makes it useful for other people who might be working on a project with you, or yourself at some future date. By using heading tags for headings, you make it clear that the meaning of the content is supposed to be a heading. Even if it doesn't necessarily look like a default heading, you know what role it's supposed to play on the page.